Des Moines police will soon change the way they respond to high-speed chases. Cynthia Fodor sat down with the chief today about her plans to tighten the rules. Cynthia?
Well, Stacey, Chief Judy Bradshaw says several officers will be reprimanded for violating the current police pursuit policy, which is now under review.
It is this chase, July 10th, captured on DOT cams throughout the city.
I noticed that Suburban being followed by about 10 or 12 Des Moines Police Department cars coming off the interstate up here on University.
The driver of the stolen SUV was the suspect in a burglary, but 10 police cars are too many to be tailing him, according to Chief Judy Bradshaw.
Bless their hearts, every officer that was available that day was aware of the stolen car. They wanted to help with the apprehension, but that's why we have the policy, you know, no more than 3 cars.
Bradshaw says the policy calls for no more than 3 cop cars on a chase to protect people like Priscilla Post, who got caught in it.
Before I knew it, they were behind me doing a pit maneuver.
We have to weigh, is this worth it? Is this worth pursuing this car, you know, in the middle of the afternoon when children are in school or maybe just leaving to go home from school, when there are school buses out?
The chief plans to change the chase policy so officers call off a dangerous chase or think twice before speeding after a fleeing vehicle. Bradshaw is confident they can still catch the suspect down the road without putting public safety at risk.
Many times, chases are called off, and then that car is seen later on in the city, moments later, by another officer, or it's involved in an accident or a situation that now we can apprehend the driver.
Chief Bradshaw says she is still reviewing the car chase that involved so many officers. They came from all different directions, and she expects several of them will be given reprimands for jumping into the chase.
All right, Cynthia, thank you.